Depuis une centaine d'années, en particulier dans les pays riches,
for about 100 years, especially in rich countries, agriculture has intensified in a very specific way, according to a very specific model. Chemistry and physics were the triumphing scientists during the positivist era, and people forgot about the biological aspects which were more difficult to apprehend. Agriculture was based on a number of chemical reactions, the effects of which one thought could be controlled, and man wanted to get rid of biodiversity, the usefulness of which in cultivated spaces were not fully understood. But agriculture progressively evolved towards a cultivated space where a single genotype was cultivated of a homogeneous plant, synchronous, providing a very homogeneous plant coverage, the genetic aspects were worked on to increase production, and there was compensation for the limiting factors, irrigation when water was missing, fertilizers for the soil, and anything that had nothing to do with the cultivated plant was eliminated. Bio attackers and biodiversity as well. Industrial agriculture, therefore, was the ultimate stage of agricultural modernization in rich countries. But this was also the starting point for the Green Revolution in southern countries, in the southern hemisphere, developing countries in Southeast Asia and India. Now, the starting point was the same. Selected varieties, elite varieties with good performance in non-limiting situations, inputs to compensate for limiting factors, water, for instance, irrigation, eradication of attackers through pesticides, and in some cases, mechanization up to a certain extent, especially in northern countries. In rich countries, agricultural transformation was a huge process. By mechanizing the process, people were able to cultivate much wider areas. The farms became bigger and bigger. Nowadays, in rich countries, with a tractor or motorized efficient equipment, one worker can cultivate 300, 400 hectares on his own, whereas in the manual agriculture at the other end of the chain in tropical areas, one person may cultivate up to 1 or 1.5 hectares, no more. So agriculture went through a real industrial revolution in countries in the northern hemisphere and the countries where the Green Revolution took place. The results were absolutely considerable in terms of yields. The yields were multiplied by 10 or 20, including in southern hemisphere countries where the Green Revolution took place. Famine was no longer a problem. Quantities became sufficient to feed the population. The necessary quantity to feed the population was achieved. India was a country where there were huge famines, and nowadays India exports cereals, although it doesn't feed its entire population, because famine doesn't necessarily depend on what is being producted, but the fact that poor people have access to the food and can buy the food. The agricultural revolution changed the agricultural landscape, but also the relationship between town dwellers and rural dwellers, agriculturists, farmers, and the rest of the population. In France, agricultural modernization led to the hedges being removed, the farms and the lands were consolidated and regrouped to increase space, cultivated space, and enclosed breeding developed. 7 million hectares of hay and fodder disappeared, and new solutions were found for breeding based on maize and protein crops, often imported from other countries, in order to intensify breeding and production.
Cette façon d'intensifier l'agriculture,
this way to intensify agriculture obviously had a huge impact.
Un des premiers effets, c'est le fait
one of the first consequences was the fact that by introducing elite varieties
basées sur des performances
based on
facteurs limitants,
performances without limiting factors, which means that a huge technological package had to be associated to the elite varieties. Unfortunately, this was done at the expense of traditional varieties, which were done away with. Many different traditional varieties have been lost among the numerous species available. Genetic progress made by industrial agriculture in northern countries and in the Green Revolution countries led to an irreversible erosion of biodiversity, which 400 generations of farmers had provided. The other consequence of the revolution lies in the fact that there has been a debate on how to best preserve nature versus an increasingly intensive agriculture with huge impacts on the environment. The debate led to two models, a very intensive agriculture, probably a polluting agriculture, but preserving nature by placing nature under a protective umbrella. Negative externalities were compensated for the protection of a number of natural areas which have become reserves. But the debate went on, and now we talk about the opposition between land sharing or land sparing. Land sharing is about sharing space between agriculture and nature, and all the effects of the cultivated space, all the actions conducted on the cultivated space have an impact on the natural space. And the other model, land sparing, is a model where two different compartments are used. In one compartment, a polluting type of agriculture, and another space for redemption where nature is preserved. But nowadays, we are becoming convinced that keeping these two compartments separate is not feasible, and we're trying to come up with a new agricultural model that takes place, that takes into account negative externalities in all of the spaces, be they cultivated or natural.